With help of Clinton, Putin announces Russian nuke energy conquers the world. There has been plenty of discussion over the past couple years regarding former Secretary of State Hillary Clinton's role in approving the sale of a Canadian-owned uranium mining company by a Russian nuclear energy corporation in 2010, a sale that vastly improved Russia's position in the global atomic energy game. A bombshell report from The Hill just provided more details on that Obama administration-approved sale, most notably that certain players in the deal were suspected of engaging in bribery, corruption, extortion and kickbacks, crimes that were overlooked by former President Barack Obama's Justice Department in order to allow the deal to go through. Part of that corruption was the funneling of millions of dollars from interested Russian officials and businesses to the Clintons by way of exorbitant speaking fees for former President Bill Clinton and hefty donations to the charitable foundation that bore his name, all while Hillary sat on the Committee on Foreign Investments, which unanimously approved the sale of Uranium-1 to Russia's nuclear energy company Rosatom. In light of that, a headline from a January 2013 article published by Russian state-run media outlet Pravda takes on a more ominous tone, as it declared, "Russian nuclear energy conquers the world." That article highlighted the incredible achievements made in the prior few years by Russian nuclear energy interests, such as the acquisition of raw material sources and various deals to either supply energy or assist in the construction of new power plants in a host of countries. The plants would be powered by Russian-provided fuel. The article made certain to note that Rosatom had finally obtained control over 10% of the shares of Uranium-1, and lacking only final approval by the shareholders, would set the stage for Russia to consolidate its control over a vast amount of the world's uranium supply, from the former Soviet Union satellite nations to Australia and South Africa. It also noted Russia's improved outlook on developing energy supply deals with a variety of European nations and cheered the gains Russia had made on the world stage. Those gains came not only in terms of economic policy and political relations, but also Russia's control over energy weapons going forward. Keep in mind this boastful article came just months after Obama mocked then-Republican candidate Mitt Romney during a presidential debate for warning that Russia was America's greatest geopolitical foe and a rival that was increasing in potential danger to the United States. Obama likely scoffed to hide the fact that he, along with Secretary Clinton, had essentially aided and abetted Russia's rise in prominence over the prior years by ceding control of the material used to produce nuclear energy and weapons. Yet, Democrats and the liberal media would have you believe that it was Donald Trump, who wasn't even considered a force in the realm of politics at the time all this occurred, who was the one who colluded with the Russian government to make Russia great again at the expense of American interests and national security. Perhaps they pursued that narrative so hard to cover up where the real Russian collusion had taken place. Please share this on Facebook and Twitter so everyone can see what Russia had to say about their nuclear energy program after Hillary Clinton and Barack Obama approved the sale of uranium supplies to them. What do you think of Clinton's role in Russia gaining greater global nuclear energy prominence? Scroll down to comment below.